So number one, not only are we promised eternal life, but what makes God's promises different to a promise from man? And I sort of already alluded to it, but I'll just show you a couple of verses. In Titus 1:2, it says here, "In hope of eternal life, which God, that cannot lie, promised before the world began." So what makes God's promises different to a promise from man? Well, it's the fact that God cannot lie. Because if God can lie, then how can his promise be 100%? And I sort of alluded to that when I said to you, you know, I'm telling you my name is Victor, but the fact that I'm capable of lying, you can never have 100% assurance of that because I am capable of lying. You can reasonably assume that I'm not telling you the truth, but when God cannot lie, we have 100% assurance that we have eternal life, because if we don't, when we believe on Jesus Christ, it would make God a liar. Look at this verse here in Numbers 23, verse 19. It says here, "God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Hath he said, and shall he not do it? Or hath he spoken, and shall he not make it good?" So it's saying here that once God says that he's going to do something, he's going to do it, because he can't lie, just like we saw in Titus 1:2. "Neither the Son of Man that he should repent." Now you might read that and a lot of people will say, well, isn't that a contradiction? Because if God doesn't repent, don't we read all through the Old Testament that God repented? But we have to read the word repent in context, because remember, repent has a single meaning, but it has to be used in context with something else, because you need to repent of something. So what does it mean here when it says that that God will not repent? Well, it's meaning here that he doesn't say something and then he doesn't not do it and make himself a liar. Because oftentimes he repented in the Bible because he was, you know, I don't have 100% understanding of this, but what I understand is that he will judge somebody. So he'll send a curse on them or he'll do something bad to them, but it was generally conditional upon whether or not they would turn. They would turn from their sins. So like Nineveh, he sent Jonah to preach unto them that Nineveh would be destroyed, but if they turned, God then repented of the evil that he said he would do unto them, and he did it not. So he wasn't lying in that sense, because generally the judgment of God in the Old Testament was conditional upon turning from their sins, that he would not send that judgment to them. So why does it say here that he will not repent? Because he's made a statement that he will bless Israel in this statement in Numbers 23 with Balaam. And it's saying that he isn't lying about that blessing. If he says he's going to bless, he will bless, and he won't repent from it. He won't make himself a liar. So, you know, does God repent? Yes, he does. But he doesn't repent if that means he's going to lie. And that's why if he's promised eternal life, he can't repent of that, because if he does, it would make him a liar. That's why the Bible says, "In hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie, promised before the world began." Because what good is a promise if it can be broken? You know, if I promise to give you $100 and I don't keep that promise, what good is that promise to you? But if I promise to you that I'm going to give you $100 and I'm not capable of lying, then you can know for sure that you have that $100, because I'm not capable of lying, you will get that $100.